Very good morning to one and all. I welcome you all for the next lecture of Production Operation Management. Kindly let me know whether my voice is audible and can you see my presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great, great. First of all, I would like to say congratulations to you for attempting. Students have attempted a Wipro campus drive test. And I wish you the good result about that campus drive. Okay, and if you are unable to attend, okay, it is your bad luck. If any update related to that, if you are eligible and applied, and then also you have not got any confirmation mail from Superset, who is the mediator for this campus drive, and if you not got any mail, then if you get any update in the future related to this, I will convey the same with you. Okay, so let's begin with the fresh morning. We'll revise some points. In the last lecture, we have discussed about the historical event in production and operational management. And in that, we have seen how this productional and operational management developed over the centuries. Okay, and it starts with the revolution in industrial sector. In the 18th century, okay, and still it is in a developing state only. The subject have not achieved yet not achieved that much maturity level, and it will develop further as the industrial revolutions comes in the picture, or it will be implemented in the industries. Like we have discussed that industry 1.0, 2.0, then 3.0, and we are approaching towards industry 4.0. So the rules and regulations, and we can say that the strategies to tackle the situation will be different in industry 4.0. so the systems which are implemented previously may not be that much effective in that area, so that we have to rethink on that and we have to develop our strategies. Okay, so then we have also discussed the functions of a production management, and that we have covered that the two steps or two different segments of functions. One is creating the availability of resources by using the available capital, and second step is nothing but using the physical resources for generating the goods and services. Then what are the different important parts which will provide this support for these two statements? That is nothing but good production of goods at the right time and in a sufficient quantity to meet the demand, then production of goods at a minimum possible rate, then production of goods of acceptable qualities. And that should be achieved to function properly, this particular production operation management. Then we have discussed by considering these two functions, we have also discussed what is the responsibility of a personnel which is working on this production management. Okay, so in that, forecasting the demand, arranging the procurement, arranging the supporting services like maintenance, storekeeping, material handling, inspection and quality, then utilizing all the factors or the resources and the services with a optimum level. Okay, with optimum level, that we have discussed in the last lecture. Now in the today's lecture, we will discuss about the scope of a production management. Scope means where we can implement production management. Okay, obviously we have discussed that the production management is implemented in any segment, no issue, but what is the scope in particular segment? Okay, this scope can be viewed in a two different categories. Okay, first one is nothing but strategic decisions. Okay, strategic decision means what? Long-term decisions. Okay, so let us say I'm running one industry, okay, which is new in market, and I have forecasted the growth of my industry for the next 10 years. Okay, so what should be my turnover? Let us say 1 crore turnover in the present year, and what should be the turnover after 10 years, let us say in 2030? Okay, I will say 100 crore will be my turnover. And what strategy you have implemented to achieve that turnover. Okay, so it is a long term business. So for that reason, you have to increase the facility, you have to increase the customer base, and you have to increase the production rate. Okay, customer increase, then only your production rate will get increased. So this point of view is with the CEO of the company. This point of view is with the proprietor, or we can say that the owner of that particular. Okay, so the higher level management always thinking in the future. Okay, and so that the decisions, some of the decision we have to take on the basis of a future demand or future forecasting. Okay, so next 5 year what will happen, next 10 year what will happen, what are our objectives. So deciding, decisions taking about that is nothing but a strategic decisions. And it also having the another point of view, that is nothing but operational level decisions. Okay, operational level decisions are the short term decisions. Okay, so let us say for 1 month, 1 year decision, what will be the production rate in 1 month, and what arrangement I have to generate, or how much machines should be utilized, how much manpower should be utilized, what will be the production rate, how I can control, or my industry will control the quality of the product. Okay, so that level decision will be considered which are short span decisions. Let us say 1 day decision also, 1 month decision also, 6 month decision also, or 1 year decision also. Okay, so that will be implemented for short time period. Okay, such a decisions will be considered as the operational level decisions. So which point of view you are having? Okay, so on that point of view, this particular production management will be implemented. Okay, so one point of view, strategic decision. Okay, long term decision, 10 year, 15 year, 20 year decisions, and the short span decisions, 1 month, 1 year decisions. Okay, decision which are implemented for short time period, such a decisions will be considered as a operation level decisions. Okay, operation level decision. Now, this decision, the strategic level decisions, are mainly concerned with the design of a product and a production system. Okay, so that will be the long term decision. Okay, design of the product. Let us say the product design is very much important. I will take the example of hotel. Okay, any worker, or we can say that the waiter is served you one food. Okay, and which is nicely designed, or it looks beautiful, and it is tasteless. After testing, you come to know that it is tasteless. Okay, so design is okay, but the customer is not satisfied with the test. Okay, once again, if that particular worker serve you the food which having good look, or we can say that it is looking beautiful, and also it tastes good. Okay, then you will get satisfied with that. Okay, you will get satisfied, more satisfied with that. So the important point is about the customer satisfaction. Okay, is about the customer satisfaction. And the golden thing is about that, if it will be in a reasonable price, then you are very much happy with the food, the service, and you will wisely visit that particular hotel. Okay, because the service is good, the food is looking beautiful, and it tastes also good. So you'll visit once in a month, once in a 6 month time period, or whatever, whenever you want to visit any hotel, or you want to go for the dinner, then you try to visit that particular hotel. Okay, so what is the more important part to retrain, or to capture the customer? That is nothing but, one is nothing but design. Okay, design in the sense which will satisfy the customer, which will satisfy the customer. Now, once again, this I will implement in a manufacturing sector. Let us consider that your company is manufacturing the car. Okay, or Tata Motor company is there, and Tata Motor is manufacturing the car. Okay, so what is more important? The functions given in that car. Okay, the rear camera, front camera, sound system. Okay, the comfort level. Okay, so these things are preferable. Also, the look of that particular car. is also important. Okay, the look of that particular car is also important. And when these two things will satisfy the customer, then and then only the customer will buy that particular car, and automatically the customer convey in the market that this car is very much important, very much having very much good feature, and its look is also very good. Okay, and comfort level is also very good. So that feedback will enhance your customer base. Okay, so it will be mouth to mouth, or we can say that mouth publicity. Okay, mouth publicity, and this will happen when you are producing a good quality product with proper design, which will satisfy the customer need. Okay, then what are the different strategic level decision? When we have discussed about the design, okay, then what is meant by new product identification? Let us take the example of future market about the EV vehicle, or we can say that electrical vehicle. Okay, so electrical vehicle is the future of India. Okay, and so that the big brand companies are trying to switch towards the electrical vehicle. Now Ola scooters are in the market. Okay, the pre-booking is started in the market related to the Ola scooter, which is one of the electrical vehicle. Now big brands, we can say that Mahindra, Tata, TVS. Okay, these companies are doing the R&D to produce a good quality product related to the electrical vehicle, so that will be having a reasonable price, and the customers will attract to their products. Okay, customer will attract to their product. Now yet in the market we are running with the petrol and diesel cars and two wheelers, but the future is what? Okay, future is electrical vehicles. So the R&D is already started in the industries, and they are launching their products in the market. Okay, and everyone want to cope up with that particular new segment. Okay, so that they have started the R&D process and the production. Some companies also started the production. So this is nothing but new product identification, determining the future demand, determining the future segment related to our company, and implementing that new segment in the company. That is nothing but new product identification and design. Related to design, we can say that it is one kind of a satisfaction level of a customer, in the sense of comfort level and the product look. Okay, then process design and planning. Okay, so what is meant by process design? What is the strategic level related to the process design and planning? So process means what? First of all, we should understand this process. Process means what? Conversion of one thing into another thing. That is the process which is used in the industry. Okay, now conversion process implemented to produce that component is nothing but a process design. Okay, let us say there are different levels of components, variety of products, and which product your company manufacturing. That is also an important thing. If your company manufacturing ship, okay, ship, jahaz manto apan tela, ship, that company is manufacturing a ship, then what type of a production layout should be there? Okay, so ship will be at a centrally located, and the people will work around that particular ship. Okay, so we cannot do the automation for that ship manufacturing. Okay, most of the sense we can say that or whatever the automation will be there, it is around the product. Okay, it is around the product. So accordingly we have to design the process. Okay, accordingly we have to design the process. Then if you say that if your company is manufacturing the toothpaste, or we can say that toothbrush. Okay, your company is manufacturing toothbrush. So for that particular product, we does not require ship like construction. Okay, or ship, for the ship manufacturing, whatever the layout we are using, the same layout will not be applicable for the brush manufacturing company. Okay, there will be a different layout, or we can say that there are different kinds of machines are used, and they are placed sequentially. Okay, if you have visited any foundry, then you can see that the how the product is flowing inside that particular industry. Okay, first of all, the raw material store is there, then that particular raw material store is near to the foundry. after the foundry fettling department is there, after fettling cleaning department is there, then after that machining department is there, and then from the front side the product will get dispatched to the customer. Okay, so process, this is the process, and depends on a product which is which you are having and how much capability to invest on the capital things, that is also important. On that basis you have to take the decision about the process design. So this decision will be will considered as a long term decision, because once you installed the machine, once you implemented a particular layout, then you will not change that layout for some time period. Okay, let us say 5 year, 10 year time period, until and unless you will not get a different product or your segmentation will not change, you will not change that layout of your industry, or you will not move the machines from one place to another place wisely frequently in a month or in a year. Okay, so that location is most important, and that installation of machines and the facilities whatever required for the production purpose, that should be installed at a specific location. Okay, after this machine, what machine should be provided, which machine should be provided after that machine, which machine should be provided. Let us say the CNC machines are there. After CNC machine, I need a quality tool, so quality department or the quality checking workstation should be there. Okay, like that decision should be there while implementing any process. So this design of a layout according to your product, that will be considered as a process design, and the planning related to that. Okay, then the third decision, we can say that the most important decision, that is nothing but facility, location and layout planning. Okay, already we have considered that the what is meant by process design. So after process design, you will come to know what will be the layout. Okay, what will be the layout of our industry, okay, which will be more efficient. Why layouts are very much important? Because we know that the material handling is also important. Now next point is also, this all the points are correlated to each other. Okay, material handling, layout and process design. As we know that we have to reduce the material handling so that the time and the money spending on material handling will get reduced. Okay, so minimum material handling principle should be implemented in the industry. Okay, minimum material handling principle, we will not avoid the material handling, but that material handling should be minimum so that the time of a material handling or material transportation will get reduced. Okay, or the fuel, the energy, the human efforts required to transport the material will get reduced. Okay, and accordingly we have to design the layout of any particular industry, depends upon the product, depends upon the product. Okay, so design, process planning, layout and handling system, material handling system, these are the correlated points. Okay, these are the correlated points. So next important is nothing but facilities location. Okay, so we will take the overview according to the market situation. Okay, so let us say the you want to install one plant which is producing the automobile components. Okay, which is producing the automobile components. So where you want to locate that components? Okay, where you want to locate that components? Where the customer base is more, at that location you will try to locate that component, that particular industry, so that your money will get saved by reducing the transportation from your location to another location. Or where you want to locate the plant where you get the raw material in a cheapest rate. Okay, where you get the raw material in a cheapest rate. So this all the decisions, okay, decision of a location of any plant or deciding any location related to your industry, that decision will be considered as a strategic decision. Because once you install that plant, then you will not move that plant according to the upcoming futures decisions. Let us say your company, nearest company, or the production department of nearest company is shut down and you want to locate your plant to another near to another company, it will not possible, right? So the location of your company is most important, and that will decide on the basis of parameters like the market demand, okay, the availability of a material, taxes which are implemented on the industry, okay. So we know that the states in India always providing the goodwill for the outcome outside industries, okay. They are offering the land, they are offering the tax, or they are offering the benefits when they locate the industry in any of the state, okay. They are offering all these things, and what we will get, okay, we will get the employment, okay. What is the benefit of that particular state? The state will get employment, that state will get the money in the sense of a taxes over the salaries, okay. So that is the benefit of a state. So selection of a state, selection of an area, selection of the machineries, okay, required for the processing purpose. So all these things comes under the facilities location. Facilities location, okay. The next thing is nothing but the design of a material handling system, okay. Designing is also important. Material handling, we know that transporting the material within the system or within the industry, that will be considered as a material handling, okay. And the system, okay, where you want automation, degree of automation, how much degree of automation you want to implement to handle the material, okay. How much degree of automation, means what, okay. So how much material will be handled by human being and how much material will be handled by the machineries. So the material handled by the machinery will be considered as a automation, okay. So for the automations, you can use the cranes, okay. For the automations, you can use the belt drives, chain drives, okay. So according decisions related to material handling, okay, which material handling is required for the industry, whether it is whether it is suitable for our industry, okay. Yes, if it is suitable, then whether it is feasible or we are capable to purchase that material handling system or not, okay. So capital available or capital allocation for that particular system is also, these parameters are also important. Now if you are producing small batches of quantities, or your production rate is not good, okay, your industry is not producing that much bulk of material or that much bulk of products, in that sense that decisions are also very much critical, okay. So because the bulk quantity or the volume of a production also impacted on all these decisions, okay. Process design also impacted by the production quantity or the volume of the production, then layout also impacted by this, then material handling system also impacted on this. Then once again, this volume of production also impacted on the capacity planning. Capacity means what? Let us say you are having 100 machine and each machine producing 100 components in one shift, okay. So you are producing 100 multiply by 100 components in one shift, okay. So this is the capacity of that particular plant, okay. This capacity 100 multiply by 100 is the capacity of that particular plant. And affecting parameters are nothing but the maintenance of the machine, then the human power available or absenteeism of the employees on workstations. So that are the that affects on the capacity of planning. So accordingly, your capacity of your plant will get fluctuated, okay, or any production department or any department will get fluctuated according to this particular impacting parameters, okay. Now this capacity, how we are going to decide the capacity? Obviously the most important parameter to decide the facility of any plant is nothing but the demand of that particular product in the market, okay. If the demand is not good for a particular product in the market, then you will not go for much capacity you will not go for the industry having more capacity, you will restrict your capacity. But if your product having more demand in the market, in that case you try to increase the capacity of your plant. Okay, so scope should be provided in the industries. Okay, and we know that let us take the comparison between the industry and our home. If you want to purchase any land, then we will purchase in a square foot and we try to utilize all the area whatever purchased for our home. Okay, and when the industry is purchasing any land, they consider about the future expansion. Okay, and accordingly they built up their construction facilities. Okay, so that extra area will be used when there is more demand in the market, and that extra area will be utilized for capacity enhancement. Okay, capacity enhancement. Okay, so once again, this part or the capacity planning is also affected by the demand of the product or the volume of the production and their demand in the market. Okay, so these are the strategic level decision need to take, and in that decisions the production management is helpful and having a scope for the industry. Then what are the different operational level decision? Okay, so operational level decisions are mainly concerned with planning planning and control of production activity. Okay, so operational level decisions are termed as a short term decisions. Okay, so what comes under this operational level decision? So first is nothing but production planning. Okay, production planning, it concerns with what we can say that determining the future course of action regarding the production to achieve the organizational objective, short term productional objective, how much production we want at the end of the month. Okay, and what actions need to take to achieve that production, that is nothing but a production planning. Then the production control, controlling means what? The quality, whatever the plan we have decided at the start of a production, execution of that plan is nothing but production controlling. Okay, we are planning something, we are deciding that this much production rate should be run every day for next 1 month, and to run that production rate, how much machine requirement is there, how much manpower requirement is there, how much raw material requirement is there, how much energy requirement is there, that we have decided already in a production planning. Now production control is nothing but whether we are running the plant, whether we are running the production according to our plan or not. If there is any problem in any of the segment, in any of the resource, then need to tackle that problem. Okay, that is nothing but a production control. Then other activities which where the productional or the production management can be implemented, that is nothing but inventory control, maintenance, replacement, cost reduction. Inventory control means what? We have already discussed what is meant by inventory. Storing the finished goods or storing the raw material is nothing but the inventory. Now controlling over the inventory, if you are investing to purchase something as a raw material, then your money or your capital will get blocked. Okay, for some time period, until and unless that material will not be sold in a market. Okay, so controlling on the inventory is most important in the industry, as you will produce more component than the requirement, and that will be stored for a long time period, then that will be considered as a loss for the industry. So inventory control is one of the most important parameter in the industry. Then maintenance and replacement, decision related to maintenance, whether any machine we require to maintain or we have to replace that machine. Okay, according to the opinion or master opinion, we can say that on that basis these decisions are taken. Okay, so a new purchased machine, 1 to 2 years machine is there, which kind of maintenance should be implemented. Okay, and how to run the maintenance activity on the basis of a plant specification or on the basis of a machine specification. And wisely I want to take you the example of sugar industries. Okay, the 6 month time period will be considered as a production time period for the sugar industries, and 6 month time period will be considered as a production time for the sugar industry, and 6 month time period is considered as we can say that maintenance time period for the sugar industry plant. So in that 6 month time period, during the maintenance, the plant is completely shut down. Okay, that maintenance will be considered as a shutdown maintenance. Okay, so I want to give this example wisely how we can plan the maintenance. Okay, replacement. Okay, replacement means what? Replacing any machine. So replacement thing is replacing with the same machine. Okay, if there is no any modification related to that machine happening in the market, okay, then replacing the same machine with the same machine, or replacing the machine with the higher technology machine. Okay, replacing the machine with the higher technology machine. For that purpose, we have a simple example: lathe machine and a CNC machine. Okay, so your production rate is very small at that time. You have purchased the lathe machine, and your product demand is increased in the market. Then you should go for the replacement of that particular lathe machine by the CNC machine or VMC machine. Okay, then cost reduction. Cost reduction. We know that at every stage we are adding the values in the product. And if you are not adding any value in the product, then that operation or that particular process will be the waste for the industry. That will be considered as a waste for the industry, and that will increase the product cost. So eliminating such a processes, such a operation from the system, so that the cost of the product, final cost of the product, will get reduced, and that reduction will be positive for the industry, and it will created or it will leads for the more profit for the industry. It will lead for more profit of the industry. Okay, is there any doubt, any question in this scope, whether you understood?
Yes sir.
Yeah, great, great. Others also reply. Okay, you can use the chat box. Okay, I know that Yasar is a very much active person and he is listening to me. But others also put up your opinion. If you want more explanation about any point, then you can ask. I'm providing the sufficient explanation. But then also, if you are not understanding, then ask the question. If my speed is very fast, you can suggest me. I will reduce the speed, or it is sufficient, then no problem, no issue. But you have to comment something about that. About the lecture, it should be a communication between me and you, or else it will be considered as a boring lecture. Okay, so you should communicate. Okay, is there any after I'm asking or in between? Okay, so if you don't have any problem, okay, someone is, Dhanashri is committed, no problem. Okay, thank you, Dhanashri. So if you don't have any problem, then you can write down the heading as a scope of production management. Have you written the previous points, this functions of a production management?
Functions of production personnel remaining.
Oh, okay. Functions of a productional personnel remaining. Okay. So write down. Thus, the functions of a production personnel are. The functions of production personnel are. Functions of production personnel are. Function of production personnel are. First one, forecasting the demand for the product. Forecasting the demand for the product. Forecasting the demand for the product and using the forecast and using the forecast and using the forecast to determine and using the forecast to determine the requirements of various factors of production. The requirements of various factors of production. The requirements of various factors of production. Second one, arranging for
the procurement, arranging for the procurement. Of required factors of production. Arranging for the procurement of required factors of production. The next, arranging for the services such as maintenance, comma, store keeping, material handling. I missed comma over here. So you store keeping, comma, material handling, comma, inspection and quality control, etc. Store keeping, comma, material handling, comma, inspection and quality control, etc. That would be required to attain the targeted level of production. That would be required to attain the targeted level of production. Then utilizing effectively the factors of production, and service facilities, available to produce the product, Okay, we'll stop. Over. Okay, so give next heading as scope of production management. In that you can write the scope of production management can be considered from the point of view of both strategic decisions influencing the production system and the operation level decisions. Okay, you can put a decision also after operation level and the operation level decision. Okay, next point, The strategic level decisions are mainly concerned. The strategic level decisions are mainly concerned with the design of product, with the design of the product and production system, with the design of product and production system. Full stop. In bracket, long-term decisions. Which are that decision? We will write that. The strategic level decisions are. First one, new product identification and design. Second one, process design and planning. Process design and planning. Third one, facilities location and layout planning. Fourth one, design of material handling system. And last one, fifth one, is capacity planning. Capacity planning. Okay. Whether in new syllabus, I don't know, but plant layout chapter was there in old syllabus in industrial engineering. Whether it is there now also or not, I don't know that. Okay, plant layout chapter, you may learn product type plant layout, process type plant layout. Okay, if your manufacturer, your company is doing some assembly process, then you required the process type layout. Okay, and your product or your company is product oriented according to design specification given by the customer. You have to produce something like boilers, like ships, like aeroplanes. Turbines, large turbines. So such a big products are manufactured according to the specification, and for the turbines we know that the complete things or the effectiveness or the efficiency of a turbine is depends upon the head available of that particular turbine, okay, or water head available at that location, for which location you are providing that turbine. Okay, so on that basis you have to decide whether it's a Pelton turbine, Kaplan turbine, okay, and anything else. Okay, and their design. Okay, all these things are depends upon the conditions of a location. So we'll not produce the turbines in a bulk. Okay, we cannot produce the turbines in a bulk having the similar features. If it is the Kaplan turbine, in that also you have to change the things according to the head availability, according to the location specifications. So for that reason, you required a product type layout, okay? Process type layout. Car manufacturing companies, two-wheeler manufacturing companies, where the standard processes are implemented, okay? So one kind of a product is continuously producing, okay? So assembly line is there. And for a particular workstation, particular task is assigned, okay? Particular task is assigned. And the vehicles are moving in a forward direction. For few minutes, the vehicle is stationary at particular location. And after completion of a time period, it will move to the next workstation, okay? So these types of companies will implement the process type of layout, okay? After one process, another process. After another process, another process, okay? So that layout is process type layout, okay? So I want to say about this layout planning, okay? Then fourth one, design of a material handling system. Design of a material handling system. Design of a material handling system. And fifth one is a capacity planning. Okay. So next, the operational level decisions are mainly concerned with. The operational level decisions are mainly concerned with. Operational level decisions are mainly concerned with. Mainly concerned with planning and control of a production activities. Planning and planning and control of production activities. In bracket, short-term decisions. Short-term decisions. Short-term decisions. Next, the operational level decisions are, the operational level decisions are, operational level decisions are production planning. First one, production planning. Second one, production control. Production planning. Second one, production control. Third one, other activities include. Third one, other activities include inventory control, comma, maintenance and replacement, comma, cost reduction, etc. Cost reduction, etc. Production planning, first one. Second one, production control. Third one, other activities include. Other activities include inventory control. Inventory control, comma, maintenance and replacement. Maintenance and replacement, comma, cost reduction, etc. Cost reduction, etc. Okay. Over. Etc. Okay, over. Okay, so next point in this chapter is types of production. Okay, types of production. Types of production. Okay, so in the types of production, we will come to know different types of production. Okay, so there are three categories of production. One is make to stock production. Second one is make to order production, and third one is assembly to order production. So now, why these categories are very much important? We know that the production system is consist of, or the convergence system, which includes the facilities, equipments, and the operational methods. Okay. Now, selection of these facilities is depend on this, or is depend on a product. Okay. Which the facility is producing. Okay. Production system which include the facilities, equipment, and operational methods or operating methods. These things are depend on the type of a product, okay? And this type of a product will lead to the type of a production, okay? Will lead to the type of a production. And we are going to discuss this three type of a production under this particular heading. First one is make to stock production, okay? So as the word is suggested, make to stock, okay? Banwa, stock karnyasathi, okay? मराठी मध्ये काय म्हणू शकतो आपण बनवा बनाइए और स्टॉक कीजिए हिंदी में बोल सकते बनाइए और स्टॉक कीजिए ओके सो व्हाट व्हिच प्रोडक्ट्स वी कैन से दैट दीज आर ऑलरेडी स्टॉक्ड एंड दे आर प्रोवाइडेड टू अस एनी ग्रोसरी आइटम यू कैन सी दैट इन किचन एनी ग्रोसरी आइटम इट इज इन अ स्टॉक एंड वी हैव परचेस डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द स्टॉक ओके वेदर इट विल बी एट अ रिटेल store, whether it that will be considered at malls and anything else. So that are already stocked, okay, there. And we are purchasing that particular products. Whether you can give any suggestion for the product at that location, that is the concerning point about the make to stock production. You will not change the design of a product. You will not change the quantity of a product in one batch. Okay, let us say, kurkure, you want to purchase kurkure of 5 rupees. Whether you can give suggestion to to the company directly that the quantity of a kurkure present in that packet is very much less, you increase that quantity. No, it will not possible in make to stock production. So which products comes under make to stock production? Okay, which products comes under make to stock production? So such a products having a specific nomenclature of off shelf standard products, off shelf standard product. They are produced, they are made available to the customer, okay? And customer will not suggest or will not change the specification of that particular product, okay? Will not change or will not give the suggestions for changes in the specification. Will not order according to your choice. Okay, you have to select whatever available. Okay, you have to select whatever available. Now, these products are manufactured in a bulk quantity. Okay, these products are manufactured in a bulk quantity and they are stored. Okay, and they are ready to available for the immediate shipment. Okay, whenever there is an order from the dealer or sub dealer, the products available in the store, they are transported at that particular location, at dealer location, at sub dealer location, or at we can say that at the retailer location. Okay, so these are the make to stock production where we cannot suggest any changes in the standard. Okay, they are off shelf products having the good quality and reasonable price. Why the price of such a product is lesser? Because they are produced in a bulk. Okay, they are produced in a bulk. When we are increasing the volume of the production, at that time the price of a product will get reduced. And when we are going for specific designing or dimensions of any product according to your specification, any product is developed, then the price of that particular product will get increased, because the skilled workers are required to change the things. The machines, specific machines are required, there need to change the jigs and fixture which are available on the machines. So the cost of that things will get added in a non-standard products, okay? So that the cost of non-standard products will be higher one, whereas the cost of standard products is lowered one, because they are produced in a large scale. And for long time period, there is no change in the design, okay? For long time period, there is no change in the design. And continuous production is happening, and they are stored for a long time period, or they are stored and they are shipped. Their shipment will happen immediately. Okay, their shipment will be happen immediately. Now, which are the standard products? We can say that automobile bearings. Okay, in every automobile, the bearings are available. We can say that. Okay, bearings are used, or for the motors, we know that 12 head motor, 10 head motor. Okay, we say that you provide me 10 head motor. Okay, if you go to the pump and motor retailer shop and you only ask that I want 10 head motor or 12 head motor or 15 head motor. Okay, so he only suggests that we have Kirloskar motor, we have Lakshmi motor, and any other another company motors. Okay, he will not give any another specification related to the motor. You just select the company. Okay, specifications are same one. Okay, you just select the company. There is no choice for a particular company for different designs for a particular product. Okay, so you want to purchase 100 gram Colgate toothpaste. Okay, plain Colgate white toothpaste. Okay, so you will get only one design for 100 gram Colgate toothpaste. Okay, you will not ask for the another design. Okay, the standard product is available for the Colgate in the market. Okay, you have to purchase that one only. Okay, so such like you want to purchase the unicorn bike or any another KTM bike in the market, you just ask about the color. You cannot modify their design. Okay, you if you want to modify, you go to another shop and modify there, no issue. But the company will offer you standard product. Okay, and by offering that things, okay, by standardizing the things, company decreases the price of product. Okay, company decreases price of product as they are produced in a bulk quantity, as they are produced in a bulk quantity. So ready to wear garment, no comment about that. You know all the things. Then nuts and bolts, standard nuts and bolts are available. You just give the specification, retailer will provide you, will not modify the design, or you will not give the suggestion to the retailer that modify nuts and bolts according to my specification. It will not possible. Accordingly, same for the television. So n number of products are in the market, whatever the products available, all the products, we can say that they are whatever you can see. Okay, your pen, pencil, mobile, laptop, everything comes under make to stock production. Okay, make to stock production. Or watches, whatever it may be, footwears. Okay, they are already produced and they are available. You just select the size and the color. Okay, that is the only requirement or that is the only choice with you in this type of a production. Okay, so make to stock production, what is the advantages? So short delivery time. Okay, so it these products are available everywhere and you can purchase anytime, and the as the they are already in a store of a company, so whenever there is an order, these products are immediately transferred to the location. Okay, and what are the limitations of this make to stock product? This the storage cost will get added in the product, so higher cost of inventory, then inability to express the customer for the design of the product. These are the limitations. Customer will not give suggestion for the company, and according to their specification, the company will not manufacture the product. So inability to express the customer for the design of the product. Then situation for make to stock production, what are the different situations? So demand is constant, fairly constant and predictable demand. Products are few and they are standardized. Shorter delivery time expected by the customer, and products are having high shelf cost. Now here, high shelf cost. What is mean by that? High shelf cost means what? More cost will get added because of the storage. Okay, so we know that any of the product is manufactured 10 rupees in the industry, and it will be sold by 15 rupees at a retailer. Okay, so what 5 rupees cost 5 rupees cost. In that 5 rupees cost, more cost is about the storage. Okay, more cost is about the storage. So high shelf cost means storage cost or keeping that product for a long period in the inventory. So that cost will get added in the product. So that is nothing but products are having high shelf cost. Okay, so these are the situation where we can go for make to stock production. Okay, where we can go for, or the industry can go for make to stock production. Getting everyone? Make to stock production. What is meant by make to stock production? Is there any doubt, any question? Whether you understood first type of production? Okay. If you have any doubt, any question, you can ask, or else just put up your roll numbers in the chat box and you can join another lecture of entrepreneurship development or entrepreneurship. I will provide the write-up of about this point in the next lecture. Remaining student, just put up your roll numbers 65, 60, 14, 47, 73, 21, and 80. Put up your roll numbers and join next lecture. I'm going to close this meeting.